I'm going to present this research work that is entitled Open Access Repository as Channel of Publication Scientific Grade Literature. This is part of the PhD dissertation of Tránsito Ferreras. I'm only the supervisor. I'm not responsible at all for the work. More or less, the idea of this work and the idea that is behind of her PhD thesis is this statement of Peter Saber. Thesis and dissertation are the most useful kinds of invisible scholarship and the most invisible kinds of useful scholarship. Because of their high quality and low visibility, the access problem is worth to solve. Then we are trying to investigate what's happening with this kind of high quality work, the work that our PhD students are working during several years, and after that, what's happening with it. Then the goals of this paper is reporting the benefits of a scientific communication model through open access repositories, reporting the benefits of scientific grey literature deposited and disseminated thesis through a repository. In this kind, we are going to use our institutional repository in Salamanca University, in so-called GREDOS, and also presenting the fundamentals and the state of the art, trends and benefits of open access. Trying to express a new model inside of scientific communications. Then, regarding scientific communication, the technological developments are changed a lot of the way that our scientific work is presented. We have new paradigms that are so related to with the development of internet as the platform for everything. In this, with this context, the open movement arises and perhaps changes the way that everyone can access to the knowledge, in this case, to the scientific knowledge. Then, I think it's not necessary to go deeper to the open access movement. It's a philosophical point of view of how we can share our advance with the humanity. Trying to make easier the way that this scientific work can be shared, usually the universities, but not only universities, establish setting up institutional repositories where the production of the staff of this institution, this case universities, could store and disseminate their works, their scientific works. What kind of contents we can store in a repository? We can store everything from our teaching, from our researching, or from our daily work, for example, in an institution with all the files, etc. Perhaps when we talk about scientific works, we think in papers. But papers are not the only scientific outcome we have. And perhaps this great literature is one of the most interesting elements that could be stored in a repository. And the most important great literature is thesis and dissemination. Talking about that, we understand great literature as every knowledge component that is not related with a publishing company. Then, talking in a specific way about theses in repositories. There is a common practice of making digital version of the thesis and dissertation available online in the repositories with the aim to be to have more visibility and accessibility to this kind of elements. Then data from the statistics of the these repositories suggests us a great increase in the use and citation of doctoral theses in the current practice of our publishing works. For all the researchers, but also for the institution, especially in this kind of ranking world that we are living, is essential achieving visibility, citation, and impact of the work. Also, to justify the budget we receive from different kind of institutions, European Union, our countries, and things like that. If we have no return of this invest, it's difficult to ask more money for continuous research. Then it's so important that this kind of repositories ensure two key elements: interoperability, just in order to change and this element between these other repositories all over the world, and also the digital preservation. As I explained before, we have an institutional repository in the University of Salamanca that is called GREDOS. And through a mandate of 2008, all the theses must be stored in this repository in an open access, with an open access policy. This way, authors have not yet transferred rights to a publisher, and theses in the citation are now born in digital. If this is the reality in our society, all the theses are born in digital, then it's easy to store it in a repository. And also, if you have your copyright, you have not signed any contract with any publisher, just in order to have to ask permissions. There are several studies, reports about what's happening with the open access elements. And usually we have the big conclusion that the elements that are open access accessible have more citation than non-open access papers. But what's happened with theses? Do open access theses have a citation advantage? There are other reports that studied the impact of the theses, and the results of these studies are not too much enthusiastic, because it's true that theses are more accessible in these electronic formats. The overall scientific impact seems to be declining. It's something that is happening with this kind of element. Then we have performed a first study trying to prove through a simple analysis how these electronic calcesis have a high degree of use and visibility, and also a small but significant citation rate. The results prove that the open access repository are a valid way to disseminate scientific grade literature of institutions and are a valid channel of publication for scientific grade literature. I'm going to try to go faster because perhaps there are too much data, and it's, I think it's better to have time for discussion. Well, we have several studies about interoperability, dissemination, visibility. We fulfill all of these in Gredos, just ensure both interoperability and visibility. Taking into account that Gredos has a high level of visibility at internet, according to this ranking, is the 17th, is ranked in position 71 of the institutional repositories of more than 2,000 repositories. Then it has a very good visibility. Well, with this, we prepare a random set of theses, and we are going to study what's happened with the citation and what is happening with this element in the repository. Then, this is the statistic that provides our repository about both views and downloads. Then, we have an important number of views and a more important number of downloads of the different in different dates of the collection of electronic theses. We choose a sample of these theses in two different periods. 2006-2007, before the mandate, and 2010-11, to have a sample after the mandate. We use the data of all the theses defended at the university in a national database, and we have the information about our repository. We have these numbers. We have 1,064 theses with 461 that are not open access, and 600 that are open access, classified also in the different branches of the knowledge. You have all the data in the paper. Then, for this paper, we selected 25 of these, and we can show what is the difference between non-open access and open access in the different branches of the knowledge. And also, studying in specific branches of knowledge, we have the different numbers or different statistics about the views, downloads, media of views, media of downloads, and presence in Google Scholar and citations. And this is the paradoxical element that I mentioned before. We have an interesting number of views, a very interesting number of downloads, but we have that this kind of scientific production is or has a low rate of citation. You have all of these for the different brands. Then, this is our first study. We can conclude that open access repository make or plays a good role in the dissemination, but we have to study what's happening with this kind of outcomes in regards to citation. We have citation, and if this is not in this paper, but if we compare with non-open access thesis, we can find that we have a very high citation rate in open access thesis, but it's still. I think we can discuss about, sorry.